Welcome to Love Fellowship Believers. Hey, we're at our new location, 1900 Martin Luther King Jr. Avenue. We would love to have you. We're located at Gillespie Park Elementary School. We're doing a new thing. God has a vision for us to increase, step up, and step out in ministry. We look forward to seeing you there.
Amen, amen. Come on, let's put our hands together for the Lord. Amen. Oh, come on, who loves him? Who loves him? Amen. Who doesn't mind blessing him in this place, worshiping him? Amen. If we're not careful, the enemy would have us to do something different. Amen. We want to make sure that we make sure we define the reason that we're here today. We're here today to celebrate God, amen. To go ahead and give him glory, amen. To go ahead and give him honor. And in spite of what might be going on, in spite of what be happening, we're here for him, amen. To give him what it is due unto him. For he did not have to bless us this week. He did not have to allow us to be here. But he has, amen. And we can take the time to give him some praise. Amen, amen. You've heard our scriptures read, 1 Kings chapter 3, and I think read verses 11 and 12. We're just going to encompass a little bit more than 11 and 12, but I want to go ahead, if you're able to, please stand to your feet and read over verse 11 one more time. 1 Kings chapter 3, verse number 11. It says, "And God said unto him, because thou hast asked this thing, and hast not asked for thyself long life, neither hast asked riches for thyself, nor hast asked the life of thine enemies, but hast asked for thyself understanding to discern the judgment." Let us pray. Father God, first and foremost, we say thank you. Thank you, God, for this time and this moment, God. Thank you for who you are and for what you do. And God, right now it's preaching time, God, and we ask that your word would be shared in the way that you would have it to be done. Help us, Father God, to open up our ears and our hearts and our minds and receive what it is that you have for us. God, we need you. We can't make it without you. God, bless us here in this place on this Mother's Day. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 You may be seated. I want to talk to you this morning about wisdom. 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 I had to switch up my glasses this morning because I wasn't seeing too well. Wisdom. Amen. Wisdom. Wisdom. Here's something about wisdom that we find. The Bible tells us, and we're looking Proverbs and all that other kind of stuff. I don't know if you've actually taken the time to do a study on wisdom, but it talks about how important wisdom is and how wisdom is needed in every single portion of our life. This Mother's Day, we're here, and I'm sure that there's mothers that can attest that they couldn't have made it without wisdom. Amen. That they wouldn't have been able to be here without wisdom. Well, here goes a portion of the Bible where Solomon is dealing with his kingship. He's dealing with now having to walk with this new title. This new title is being king. And we've had some folk that have recently had some babies, and in having some babies, they're now a new mother. And I don't remember, I don't know if you can remember the first time as a mother you had a child. And that first child that you had, and maybe that feeling that you had of, maybe I don't know how to change the diaper correctly, or I don't know how to do this correctly, or I don't know how to do that, or maybe the anxiety of having a child might have gotten to the point where it overwhelmed you. You know, I don't know how I'm going to make it. Now that the baby's here, I got to buy this extra, and I got to do this, and I got to do that, and all the different things that come along with that. But if God has chosen you to be in that position, then I'm here to tell you, whatever position it is in your life, if God has chosen you to be in that position, he's going to give you everything that you need. Amen. Amen. And so Solomon here is king, coming into this new position, says, you know what? I'm in this position and I don't know exactly how to do it. So he turns to what he knows, and he turns to God, and he says, God, if you bless me and give me what it is that I need so that I can do what it is you've called me to do. Sometimes in a position as a parent, that's exactly what we have to do. We don't know exactly how to handle a situation. We don't know what's going on. But what we say is we say, God, give me the wisdom to handle this situation so that I can make it through. Just this morning, there was some stuff going on. I'm sorry, I apologize for not getting around to everybody for meet and greet, but I had to be father before I was pastor, amen? And so I had to walk and I had to go out and I had to say, God, I need some direction on how to handle this situation so that I could move forward. And there's nothing wrong with that. The thing that's wonderful about it is that God answered Solomon's prayer. He says, Solomon, not only will I go ahead and bless you with what it is that you've asked me for, he says, but behold, I've done according to thy words, verse 12. Lo, I have given thee a wise and an understanding heart, so that there was none like thee before thee, neither after thee shall there arise like unto thee. And I have also given thee that which thou hast not asked, both riches and honor, so that there shall not be any among the kings like thee all thy days. The Bible lets us know that obedience is better than sacrifice. So that in Solomon's obedience, instead of being concerned more about himself, but being concerned about the position that God had placed him in so that he could do what it is that he was supposed to do, God not only blessed him and gave him what he needed to fulfill the position, but he also gave him even the more. As a mother and everything that you go through. I'm not a mother. I can only speak from a parent. I can only speak from a parent seeing a mother go through. I know that there's many things that my mother went through. There's many nights that she would make sure that I had a plate, even if she didn't have a plate. There's many a time she'd make sure I'd have clothes, even if she had to wear the same thing over. There was times that she'd make sure I had an extra blanket, even if she was freezing in her room herself. But God gave her everything that she needed to do what it is that she needed to do. I want to talk to you about a real mother. Amen. Is that all right? Can I talk to you about a real mother? This same chapter. Anybody ever read 1 Kings chapter 3 before? This same chapter, if you continue on reading down in this same chapter, Solomon is, once he's given this wisdom and everything, he's then starting down in verse number 16, he's then given an opportunity to display his wisdom. Gets down to verse 16, and I'm going to paraphrase. If you want to look at it and read along while we're here, that's all right. Gets down to verse 16, and verse 16 starts off and says that there was two women. And these two women, they both became mothers. They both had a child. They both lived in the same house. After they had their children, they were asleep one night. And unfortunately, one of the mothers in her sleep rolled over and smothered her child, and her child died. Well, the mother that had accidentally smothered her child and died in the middle of the night, she got up. She went to the other woman's room with the dead baby. She laid the dead baby beside that mother, and she took her child. So the morning came, and when the morning came, the woman woke up, and she found that she had a dead child beside her. Of course, you could probably imagine how she felt. But then she noticed that the child that was dead was not hers, and that now the other woman had her child. Is everybody following me? Is everybody with me? And so the two women said, well, wait a minute. Back then, they didn't have the court system, and they couldn't call the police and all that other kind of stuff like we would do today. But what they did is they said, okay, now we're going to the king. 1 Kings chapter 3. Now we're going to the king. And now that they're at the king, they come to the king and they say, well, king, this is our situation. And they go through and they explain all of that. Now, as the first time that I read this story, I was threw off. Because I was like, well, gosh, how in the world would you take care of a situation like that? Solomon listens and he hears each side of the story. He says, I tell you what, to make it even, to make it fair, he said, bring me a sword. And he commanded that the baby that was still alive be chopped in half. He said, in that way, you give half to one mother and you give half to the other mother, and they'll be okay. One of the women yelled out and cried, please, please, no, just let her have the baby. Don't kill the baby, don't cut the baby in half. The other woman said, yes, cut the baby in half. That'll make it fair. Solomon sat back in wisdom and said, well, the real mother, you take the child and you give the child to the mother that did not want the baby to die. Because the real mother wouldn't want her child to die. Amen?
Amen.
I read that story and I said, wow, look at the wisdom that he displayed here. And so I want to give you an acronym for a real mother. Amen? Now, notice before we get ready to do this, I'm not giving you an acronym for a perfect mother. Because there's not a perfect mother. But I want to give you one for a real mother. Amen? Amen. Amen. So we've gone through this and we've seen the importance of wisdom and all of that other kind of stuff. The first thing that I want to give you is I want to give you an R. A real mother is reliable. That does not mean that a real mother is going to have all of the resources and all of that other kind of stuff. That doesn't mean, let me speak to some children. It doesn't mean that a real mother, that just because you say you want it, she's going to give it to you. But a real mother is reliable. Reliable in the sense of that when you really need her to be there, she'll be there. Amen? A real mother. A real mother is efficient. Because of being a real mother, that means that, and we see in the Bible in Proverbs where it talks about a virtuous woman, to be efficient, that means that there's a whole lot of things that a mother has to juggle. Okay, I got one amen on a whole lot of things that a mama has to juggle. Amen. There's a whole lot of things that a mother has to juggle. There's a whole lot of things that a mother has to try to take care of to make sure her household runs efficiently. Even as a single mother, there's a whole lot of things that a mother has to make through. She don't have nobody else that she can say. She said, no, I got to make sure this happens. So when I got to put on my daddy hat, I got to put on my daddy hat. And when I, okay, there's somebody that knows what I'm talking about. Amen. She has to be efficient. My mother used to call it, God bless her, she's not here today. My father wasn't feeling well. They've gone to the doctor. But my mother used a phrase that even sticks with me today. She says, I had to rob Peter. Come on now. And so in being efficient, a mother knows what's most important to say, well, look, I need to take care of this to make sure this is taken care of, and I need to make sure that's taken care of. And oftentimes in the equation, when the mother is running around to make sure this is being taken care of, that's being taken care of, she does it in a way to make sure that the children get everything what she needs. She'll do it in a way to even make sure her man gets everything that he needs. And she'll put herself on the back burner. A real mother. A real mother is reliable. A real mother is efficient. A real mother is admired. Amen. Again, notice I said before we even got started, I'm not talking about a perfect mother. But a real mother is admired. If she ain't admired by nobody else, she ought to be admired by her children.
Amen.
Her children ought to look up with her in admiration and say, wow, my mom. Now, here goes the part that's a little tricky. Because at the age where the children are over there in the children's church, a lot of times they don't realize everything that a mother goes through. But when we get a little bit older, and we start to look back on the mess that we used to do, And the way we used to handle things, we start to find out that mama meant a whole lot.
Amen.
That mama, even if it comes time when we become a parent ourselves, we start to realize that mama made a whole bunch of sacrifices. And unfortunately, if God chooses to take mama home, hopefully we've realized that before that time has actually occurred. Mother is admired. Amen?
Amen.
So we have a mother, a real mother is reliable. A real mother is efficient. A real mother is admired. And a real mother loves. And so now if we start to talk about love and a mother's love, is there anybody that can think of one word that defines a mother's love? Because I couldn't. I couldn't think of one word. Unconditional still to me didn't get it all. Because a mother love goes to me even goes beyond unconditional. Because a lot of times as humans, we think of love as making sure something was done for me. But I could recall times that my mother did things that I didn't necessarily think that that was showing me love. Okay, I can think of the times I got beatings. There ain't nobody else wanna. I'll go ahead and throw it on that. Dick, you hear me? You understand what I'm saying? Okay, so I can think of times that my mama made me go get my own switch. And beat my own tail. She tear me up with the switch that I just went and got her with. I didn't see that as unconditional love. I didn't understand that as being unconditional love. I understand it now. Well, I understand some of those beatings now, but I didn't see it as that. But a real mother, she's able to see beyond of what we see right in front of us. And she's able to see a bigger picture. That bond that a mother has, that she's carried this child so many months and all that other kinds of stuff. As a father, yeah, I can be the man that I'm supposed to be and I can do all of that kind of stuff. But there was a bond that happened long before I even saw my child. That happened with a mother. And so that mother, in going through that process, has a vision of how she wants the child to be and the things that she wants for. So she's able to see down the road and see things that I can't see. Sometimes as a father. I liked, I think Brother Brian said godly. I liked even that word godly, but still not even encompassing at all. Because isn't that how God does us? God already knows what he has planned for us, what he has set up for us. And even when we get out of line, he gives us an opportunity to get back in line. He gives us an opportunity to get things back in order. We're talking about wisdom today. And as a real mother, she's able to apply wisdom to all of the situations because she's not just looking at one thing, but she's looking at an overall picture of how to go ahead and make it all work together. So that it all works out for the best. I don't know where you are in life right now if on this Mother's Day, if you're dealing with the loss of a mother, if you're dealing with in a relationship with a mother, if your teenage child is getting on your nerves as a mother or whatever, I just want to encourage you today to let you know that we've all had a mother, regardless of it's our biological mother or if it's someone has stepped in as a mother figure. I think that's the ultimate blessing from God. Yes, he gives us salvation. Yes, he does all of these different things. And of course, I'm not talking on that level, but I'm talking about here on earth. I think one of the most ultimate blessings that God could give us is a mother. a real mother. A mother doesn't always get her due. A mother doesn't always get back what it is that she puts in. Maybe that's the encouraging word for you today. To look back on that relationship and whatever things can get right and can get straight in that to make sure that that happens. As we understand what a real mother is. That's where wisdom comes in. That's where we apply wisdom in our lives. Solomon was in a situation and he says, I don't understand how to do it. I don't know how to govern your people. I don't understand what it is that I need to do. And so when he found himself in a place of where it is he didn't know how to do something that he needed to do, he called upon the Lord. Today, whatever situation, after we've talked about all these little different things that you find yourself in, well, Pastor, you don't understand how it is. My mother's not here anymore, and Mother's Day is not a joyous occasion for me, and I haven't lost my mother. I can't sit there and try to tell you how you should be or how you shouldn't be, but what I can tell you to do, that if you would ask the Lord for wisdom and how to deal with it, he'll give you what you need. I can't say, well, Pastor, you don't understand. Me and my mother don't talk no more. And me and my mother are going through this and going through that. And yeah, sometimes those things happen. But I can tell you that if you'd ask the Lord for understanding of how you need to respond or how you need it to get right, he'll show you how to fix it. Well, no, Pastor, that's not me. I talk to my mother. But me and my mother don't have the best relationship. Well, I'm here to tell you that if you want a better relationship, do like Solomon did. Ask the Lord and let him help you out with it. Amen? Amen. 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 It's personal decision time. Would you stand to your feet here, please?
Thank you for fellowshipping with us here at Love Fellowship Believers. I hope something was said, something was done that really touched your heart, and God is starting to work and change your life for the better. We would love to have you to continue to come out and fellowship with us. We're at 1900 Martin Luther King Jr. Avenue in the beautiful city of Greensboro, North Carolina. We're located actually in Gillespie Park Elementary School. We look forward to having you to come out and fellowship with us. Remember, God loves you, and so do I.